and today I'm going to be your trainer. And you guys have chosen the webcast Sponsor Quality Management, Risk-Based Risk Management Requirements and Approaches for Compliance. So throughout the call, I will be giving you time to ask questions and clarifications. But let me tell you just a little bit about me. I've been in healthcare for a long time. I've been in clinical research for a long time. I am a nurse, and I am kind of referred to as a CRA at heart. I generally work on the operations side and manage trials. I started out as a study coordinator and was a CRA, still do CRA work. I love CRA work. And I've managed quite a few trials. I've managed some really large trials. And one of the ones where I really cut teeth on this risk-based quality management approach was before it became in vogue. And that was in 2009, 2010. It was a 17,000 patient trial with 1,200 sites in 50 countries. And we employed a city by design approach. And the trial went really, really well. So I gained a lot of experience with some of the things I'll be talking to you about today. And that was while the addendum was being written. So, you know, that's just a little bit about me. And a lot of what I'll be talking to you today, I think, will be about how you want to implement this within your organization. So our agenda for today includes the welcome. We just completed that, reviewing the learning objectives. We'll do that shortly. I've already told you about me. We'll talk about quality management risk-based approaches to clinical trials, and we're really going to focus on Section 5. That's the webinar that you have chosen, and how that looks as an end-to-end process. That's sort of an affectionate term that we use in industry. I don't know where it started, but it talks about all the way from developing your protocol, planning up front, all the way through to the clinical reporting phase, and what the new guidance says about how you should employ the requirements within the guidance. We'll talk about some suggestions for successful implementation. We'll have a summary. Again, we'll have time for questions for you. And then we will review the learning objectives again. So in terms of learning objectives, after completion of this course, you should be able to describe two new requirements for sponsor quality management of clinical trials. You should be able to identify two approaches to achieve compliance with the quality management for the life cycle, and that's the end-to-end process. And you should be able to determine your next steps for evaluating and implementing the new requirements. And so let's first talk about the drivers for the addendum. And when we go through the changes that you are asking about, learning about, you will see why they changed certain parts the way they did. So as you know, there had not been a change or an update in this guidance. The original guidance was written in 1996. And at that time, there was a lack of trust during the last 20 years, there's been a lack of trust of ICH GCP statements in the submission of audits. And those audits, as you well know, make their way either in form of an audit certificate or statement into the applications. So when you do your applications for your devices, you are likely saying, okay, we audited X, Y, and Z, there were no major findings, you know, here are our certificates, or whatever you provide in your audits. There was also an overwhelming thought that there was lack of transparency. And in terms of lack of transparency, the agencies and regulators that are involved with ICH felt like that companies were working with their groups in silos, and that there was no corporate definition of quality, and that quality was not being defined up front. Likewise, they felt like that when the submissions were being made and when data was being reported, that there was no transparency. So a quality by design, not chance, agenda started to form. And this is where the Citigroup came in to play. And quality by design is looking at your protocol and your risk assessment right up front. And that's where we talk about the end-to-end process, and we start to talk about state what your quality is going to be, what your risks are, how you're going to mitigate them, and don't just throw it up in the air and let the monitors go out and find something, data management find something. Work together and figure out how you're going to manage your trial. Do it up front.